Well, Liam, there's been a lot of funny reaction to the shoe toss and everything like that. I'm sure you can prepare to block and to, you know, do all the football things, but you could never expect something like that to help you win a game, right?
Yeah, absolutely. That was pretty crazy. I mean, I saw it happen, and I just saw him throw something, and I wasn't really even sure what it was at first. I was like, wow, like that could give us a first down. Like that could kind of give us a chance to win the game here, like a second chance after we didn't get it. So definitely not a conventional way to move the chains, but I will take it. So.
And a quick follow-up, what was your perspective of the field goal? Could you see the goal post? Could you see the ball go through?
I could see it. It was a little foggy. Obviously, it was a little foggy, but from my angle, I wasn't sure if it had leg or not. And then obviously, it clearly did. It would have been good from like 65. But yeah, it was exciting. Definitely very exciting. So,
Liam, I feel like every week you have to sit there and answer these questions from us about like the culture and the locker room and stuff like that. So I guess what have you seen over the past week that kind of led to the response you saw from the team Saturday?
Yeah, you know, it's what I've been saying throughout the season. You know, we've obviously had some low points. There's been a lot of times where it could be tough to kind of get motivation to keep going. You know, but like I said throughout the year, we had the guys on this team, like we're going to keep working no matter how hard it gets, you know, and no matter how tough the circumstances seemed around us. And I'm really happy that it was able to kind of pay off and we were able to get a big win on the road against a top 10 team. So.
And Liam, on that too, Jabril Cox kind of said last week, if y'all were 8-0, a lot of things would be different. How much did the win help?
Yeah. You know, it really helps morale. You know, like I said, even though we didn't have the best work record, we were still coming in here every week and really working as hard as we could. You know, and when you're not getting the results with wins on Saturday, it becomes pretty draining. So to kind of get that sour taste out of our mouth and get like a big win, it really boosts morale on the team and just going forward. And hopefully we'll be able to keep the ball rolling this Saturday. Yeah, and build some momentum going into the off season. So.
And then obviously, you know, there were some injuries, and Cam Wire kind of slid around, you know, Saturday. I mean, what did you see from him kind of moving in a guard, and had he practiced much there?
Yeah, that was awesome. You know, he hadn't practiced too much there. We knew that that he might be the guy to go in at guard if something like that did happen where Chasen went down. You know, and that's a credit to him. You know, he's been kind of the sixth man on the offensive line the whole year, and he's done a great job. You know, always staying ready to play guard, tackle, wherever we need him to be. So that's a credit to him to be able to be versatile like that and step up on the road in a big, close game like that, you know, when he might not have been expecting to play like he did.
And, Liam, this week, early signing period, a lot of recruits making their decisions. You were once a recruit. Kind of stuck near home the first time and made your long journey as a transfer. It seems like in the locker room, there are a lot of, you know, players from all over the country. And your adjustment to Louisiana, your perspective as someone who's far from home, how does, you know, a player deal with that? And how does LSU make that work?
Yeah, for me coming down here, I've been able to adjust really through football, you know, and trying to lean on like the guys and the coaching staff here at football to get me kind of acclimated to living down here in Baton Rouge in the South, obviously very far away from home up in Boston. You know, and especially in this year, that can be difficult with everything kind of closed down or not functioning as it usually would without COVID and everything. But really that's what we've done as a team is try to kind of be there for each other and help each other through, you know, being away from home, not having as many social outlets as we usually would and whatnot, so.
Hey, Liam.
Liam, last week the offense was responsible for scoring 31 of the 37 points, and Ole Miss comes in with a pretty big reputation for putting up a lot of points. Can you talk about the mindset offensively? To, if you're going to get in a shootout, you've got to do your part and try to, execute and maybe control the clock somewhat with your running game as well.
Yeah, absolutely. That's something that we're going to have to do this week. This is a good team, football team that we're playing on Saturday. And we're going to have to show up to play. It's going to be a big game for us as an offense to really try to take control and see what we can do and build off last week where we did some good things for sure against Florida. Definitely can always improve, though. After watching the film, there's more stuff that we could have done better. Change a couple things here and there, and who knows what else could have happened for us. So just like every week, we just got to keep building and try to take the next step as an offense this Saturday. So,
hey, Liam, you mentioned momentum a couple minutes ago, and just kind of building on that and heading into the 2021 season and off season and whatnot. I mean, just what does that look like for you guys over these last 2 weeks? I mean, just as an offense, what are some goals that you guys are trying to accomplish, and just kind of how can you build that momentum over these final two games?
Yeah, throughout the whole season, really what we've been trying to do is just maximize our potential. I really believe that we have a lot of talent on this football team and on this offense specifically. And there's definitely been a lot of times throughout the year where some things didn't go as we would have hoped, and we weren't able to make plays where we wanted to make plays. But I think it's huge for this team and this program to finish like we did last weekend and go into this weekend and finish this season strong and really have some good momentum going into this off season, getting preparation for next year. So,
Liam, Max Johnson throughout the year, sometimes you come into a game at Auburn and the score's out of hand, or Alabama, the score's out of hand. But what did you see out of him in terms of the fact that he prepared as the starter. He took the first snap. He was the guy all the way, and the way that he grew throughout that game as well.
Yeah, he was awesome on Saturday. By no means was he perfect, but stepping up as a true freshman, making his first start and in a big road game in the Swamp, that's impressive. And he has gotten time throughout the year, obviously. But, this was really the first time that he was the guy. And he got that chance to be the guy. And I'm happy for him that he got to have that opportunity. And he really took it and ran with it. So, I'm not surprised that he was able to do that, though, just by the way that he prepares week in and week out and just his work ethic. And I'm looking forward to this Saturday and, hopefully try to build on it as an offense for us and for him individually. So,
you feel like that was the loudest crowd you played in front of this
year? Yeah, it probably was. Yeah, it was. Obviously, it's still, I'm sure, wasn't the same as full capacity or whatnot, but it was cool. It felt like I was getting some of the SEC LSU experience that I might have been missing out on earlier in the year. So,
hey, Liam, well, this is going to be your last game of the season coming up Saturday. How has the year been for you overall? How would you describe what has been a bit of a roller coaster season for y'all?
Yeah, that's definitely a way to describe it. I'd say it's been a roller coaster. There's certainly been some trying times for us throughout the year where we really had to kind of lean on each other, and lean on each other and get kind of motivation to keep working and keep giving everything we have throughout the week for these Tuesday practices and Wednesday practices that they're tough, but they're important for us as a team to prepare on a week-to-week basis and just develop in general. Obviously this season hasn't gone as we would have hoped, but hopefully we'll be able to finish strong this Saturday, like I've been saying, and carry some momentum into this offseason. So,
and what do you think just about how this year has been with so many freshmen and sophomores getting playing time? How do you think that's really going to elevate them going into next season?
Yeah, that's huge. You're looking at the future of the program, the future of the team right here. These guys are going to be around for a couple more years at least. And to get them on the field and see them not only playing but making plays and going on the road and beating a top 10 team, like that's very promising for the future, and that's a great experience for all these guys that have been able to get playing time and do well. So.
And Liam, one game left here in the regular season for you guys. Ogeron hasn't kept it that he's wanted to re-recruit you and bring you back. I mean, I'm sure that's something you probably thought of some now. I mean, at what point will you kind of reflect and go through that process and think about what you might do?
Yeah, so I've been thinking about it. You know, I'm really just focusing on finishing this year, finishing this week out. You know, play this game this Saturday, hopefully finish on a high note, and then kind of reevaluate next week and see where I'm at, so and what I want to be doing looking towards next year.
We'll wrap up with Wilson.
Liam, just one of those freshmen that we've talked a lot about, Kayshawn Butte, with back-to-back 100-yard games here since Terrace opted out. Was there something that y'all could see that made you think this could be coming from him when he was going to get that opportunity to kind of become the number one, that he could really take that role?
Yeah, he's got as much talent as anyone. There's a reason why he was the type of recruit he was. Even when we had all those guys before any of the opt-outs or whatnot, he was still someone that we were looking to see if we could find a way to get him on the field and get him involved in the offense just because of all the talent that he has. And now with him being kind of one of the number one guys at receiver, he's really kind of stepped up and ran with his opportunity like a lot of guys have. I feel like I've been saying that a lot throughout this interview, which is promising for the future of this team and the future of the program. So.
Thank you, Liam.